end came on Dainton Bank, and a following class 50 was summoned to push the train over the summit to Totnes, where it terminated. Drysllwyn. Both journeys passed without incident, the locomotives running perfectly.
He's in crawlers, in white, Peter. He don't really want to know. Well, I know it's a beautiful thing, man. I'm not big boy. Except he goes down. Going right down there. Yeah.
Come on, get up the freaking car.
A rerun of the ill-fated
Thank you. including 5051 Drysllwyn Castle. Sadly, on the 7th of March 1987, she was to make what was to be her last run on the main line. She's seen here leaving King's Sutton. Here, climbing Hatton Bank. By the time Stratford was reached and the engine had turned, the snow showers of the morning had merged into a steady snowstorm. From here on, it would be hard going. Drysllwyn Castle was built at Swindon in 1936, but was named Earl Bathurst in 1937. The Earl names were originally applied to the Duke Dog 440s, but the story goes that one of the Earls concerned objected to his name appearing on such an insignificant old-fashioned engine. So the name was transferred to this locomotive. The name Drysllwyn Castle was reapplied in 1949. Till 1950, and a total of 179 machines would be constructed, including some rebuilds from the Stars and a rebuild of Churchward's solitary Pacific, the Great Bear. 5051 was one of the earlier batches, leaving Swindon Works in 1936. Later in her life, she was to be named Drysllwyn Castle. She's seen here on her last main line run from Didcot to Tyseley during March 1987. During the 1930s, these were the GWR's frontline express power and achieved many notable feats, especially on the Cheltenham Flyer, the world's fastest train. They were very economical engines. Indeed, the fuel consumption figures for one of the class, Caldecott Castle, were the best of their time. Locomotive exchanges with both the LNER and the LMS showed that Churchward's careful attention to front-end design and boiler proportions had developed into an engine of great power for its size. The class did have several weaknesses: the awkward attachment of the outside cylinders, inaccessible valve gear, and the need for the very best Welsh coal. However, all these problems were minimized by the superb maintenance standards on the Great Western of the 1930s.
We're going to have a hell of a laugh at Christmas, though, aren't we?
Me, comes to be a fairy.
That's it, wandering across the picture and back again,
wandering about looking grotty, not actually doing anything.
Thank you. Right away, Rich.
Yeah, different cars, not Mark.
I come from around here, that's why I'm not...
shop.
Oh, lovely, yeah. Thank you.
Right.
Very nice.
You're alright, it's a bit lingo in here.
Thank you. day.
I'm only joking, we're not together really. Come on, thanks for the feeling.